So, let me share my screen. Yeah, Naresh, you are asking something. What is that? Permission, please. Not this one, Naresh. Okay, Naresh, Naresh, Naresh. Yeah, Naresh, you can record the session, okay? Right, you are asking something, Naresh. One login, one permission. What is that? I didn't remember that question. Yeah, Naresh. Okay, any guys, any questions, any doubts? Okay, so there is a difference between a login and the user now. Okay, now is it clear what is the difference between a login and the user? Login is a server level principle. Okay, in case you want to connect to the SQL server, a login should be created in the SQL server. Those who are in the logins list, they only can connect to my SQL server. That is the first important thing. Again, if you can connect to the SQL server, don't think you can access the databases. Okay, if you are connected to the SQL server, don't think you can access the databases. Okay, again, for accessing the database, you need extra permissions. Okay, might be you can connect to the SQL server, but if you don't have access to the database, what is the use? Okay, what is the use if you don't have access to the database? There is no use. Okay, so again, if you want to connect to any database, okay, again, I have to provide separate permissions on that particular database. So a login is a server level principle. A user is a database level principle. Right now, can anyone tell me what are the server level securables and what are the database level securables in SQL Server? Just tell me one server level securable and one database level securable. Just one server level securable and one database level securable. You know the answer. You all know the answer. What is the server login. Level securable?
Login is server level securable.
Login is not securable. Okay. Login is a principle. Who are accessing is a principle, right?
Database is server level securable.
Very good. Excellent. Database is server level securable.
Tables.
Very good. Tables super. Is, so tables is tables are
sir, database
securable. That's a. It. That's it. Excellent. Okay. So tables are database level securables, whereas databases are, see here in the same case, tables are database level securables, right? Okay, and databases are server level securables. Databases are server level securables and tables are database level securables, right? Again, for example, this Sudarshan wants to access the whole database. We can give access on the whole database so that he can access all the tables in the database. No, I don't want to give access to Sudarshan all the tables. I want to give access on a specific table. You can give access on a specific table. Don't think like Sudarshan is a member of the database means Sudarshan user can access all the tables. No, you can still restrict him. If you give the whole database, if you give permissions on the whole database, he can access all the tables. Or else you want to give access only on a single table, you can restrict Sudarshan to access a single table. That much flexibility is there in the SQL server. Whatever he needs, he can only access those particular securables, not more than those securables. Clear? Any issues, any doubts? So today I'll show you how to create a login. Okay, how to create a login, and I'll show you with the demo and all so that you will get an idea how to create a. See, again, there are three types of logins. One is a Windows login, second one is a SQL login, third one is a group login. Okay, I'll show you Windows login, SQL login, and group login in today's session. So if any questions are there, let me know. Otherwise, we'll jump into the demo.
Shanmukh, for all this process, the accessible is through email or?
Yes, yes. The process is there. Usually, they will raise a tickets. Okay, users, those who are seeking permissions, they have to raise a ticket. And again, in case they raise the ticket also, we cannot give the permissions. Okay, some people will directly raise a ticket. Okay, but what we have to check is related to the permissions. We have to check the user approvals, manager approval. Manager should approve this request. Manager should send an email. Okay, please. Okay, give right access to Sudarshan. He has to approve that request. Users will raise a lot of requests, but don't think once he raised a request, we will immediately give the permissions and all. No, especially related to the permissions, we have to check the manager approvals directly. On his face, we can tell him, I don't see any manager approval. Please get back with the manager approval so that I can give the permissions. Directly, you can tell them. Don't create any logins or don't give any permissions to any database or tables for a login without having proper manager approvals. That is very important. After, like, if you give access on a database to a user, later manager will ask you why you gave the permissions without having my approvals and all. It will create a problem. Again, permission related things, you should check a ticket first. Someone will comes to your desk, hey Bharat, can you please give me read access on this database? No, you cannot entertain those kind of things. Directly tell them, please raise a task for this. Okay, and make sure this task is approved by your manager so that I can give you the permissions. We can directly say, we can tell them. Why? Because ultimately we will be in the risk if you provide the access without having manager approvals. Okay, we will be in the risk. Finally, we will be in the risk. So to avoid those risky situations, must and should, you should have a ticket. Okay, and manager approval also should be there. Any questions, any doubts? Right, okay. Fine. So let's jump into the demo. Now I want to create a Windows login. Okay. So what should be there in case if I want to create a Windows login? Right, okay. Or else let me keep it here. Right. Remember, guys, how can I log into the SQL Server? My login is there, right? That's why I can connect to the SQL Server, right? Where is this login? Where it is there? Where it was created? Where is this login is created?
Windows machine.
Very good, excellent. In the Windows machine. So in case if I want to create a Windows login, what should be there? What is the prerequisite for creating a Windows login? What is the prerequisite for creating a Windows login?
He should be having a local account or Active Directory account.
Super, super. Okay. So a Windows user account should be there. Okay. It's a prerequisite for creating a Windows login. See here, you can see the username with computer name, right? Administrator is a part of the Windows machine, right? Every laptop will have administrator account, right? As administrator account is already there in the Windows level, then only the SQL login is created for this particular user administrator. Okay, so again, if you want to create a Windows login, a user should be there either in the Windows machine or else in the Active Directory. as of now, forget about Active Directory. What is Active Directory? What is the role of the Active Directory in the security, in the organization? We'll discuss it later. As of now, if you want to create a Windows login, a Windows user should be there in the Windows level or Active Directory level. So we'll concentrate on the Windows level. So in case if I want to create a Sudarshan login, Windows login, there are two types of logins, guys. One is Windows login, second one is SQL login. If I want to create a Windows login, Windows user should be there. Again, don't confuse. This is Windows user. For this Windows user, I can create Windows login. Okay, for this Windows user, then only I can create a Windows login in the SQL server. Okay, for this Windows login, okay, I can create a SQL user. This is Windows user, this is Windows SQL login, and this is SQL user in the database level. This is SQL user and this is Windows user. Don't confuse. User, same name is there. This is a Windows user. It should be created in the Windows machine level or AD level. Okay. In case if I want to create a Sudarshan Windows login, okay. If I want to create a Sudarshan Windows login, a Sudarshan Windows user should be there. Then only I can create a Sudarshan Windows login. In case if I want to give access to this Sudarshan login on any database, once you give access, a Sudarshan SQL user will be created in that particular database. Okay, don't confuse. This is also user, this is also user. This is Windows level user and this is database level user. Okay, don't confuse. Okay, please don't confuse. Right, now I want to create a Windows login, right? So what is the prerequisite? A Windows user should be there. Right, now let me create a Windows user then. Okay, how to create a Windows user? Open run. Type lusrmgr.msc. lusrmgr.msc. Control C. In case you want to see here, you can see here. Control V. L local usr user mgr manager. Local user manager.msc. By using this shortcut, you can open the screen. Okay. In case you want to create new users or groups, this is how we are going to create. And again, this is not our work, guys. We won't create any users in the Windows level or Active Directory level. This will be done by the Windows team. Okay. For our practice, we are the Windows team. We are the network team. Okay. So that's why we have to know how to create the users and all. It's always good to have knowledge on this. Now I want to create a Sudarshan. We'll go with the same example. Go to users. In case you want to create a group, you can go to the groups. You can create a group. Now I want to create a user, right? Let me go to the user. Let me create a Sudarshan user. How to create it? Right click, new user. Okay, Sudarshan. Right? So control A, control C, tab, full name not required, description not required, password. Okay, just password. Give the strong password. Again, don't give different passwords. You will forget the password and all. 1, 2, 3. Okay, right. Before doing this, before creating, let me create a SQL login for Sudarshan. Right click, new login. Just a minute, guys. Right, okay. So once, how to create a login? Go to logins, right click, new login. Now you can see two types of logins. One is Windows authentication login, second one is SQL Server authentication login. I'm going to create a Windows login, right? Windows authentication means Windows login, SQL Server authentication means SQL login. Right, go to search. Okay, now I want to create Sudarshan, right? Sudarshan, just click on check names. It will throw error like this. Why? Because there is no user created in the Windows machine. An object or user or built-in security principle. See here, security principle. Principle means what? Login, right? With the following name cannot be found Sudarshan. Check the selected object types and locations. Like this, it is saying there is no name, there is no user with name Sudarshan. So we have to create user Sudarshan. Okay, just we'll keep this as it is. Let me go back again. Okay, so here what we can do is, right, so let me go to this window. Sudarshan gave the password, right? Uncheck this one. User cannot change password, password never expires. I am just selecting these two. Okay, just close it. Sudarshan is created now, right? Let me minimize this window. Let me go to this window now, the same window. Earlier we got the error, right? Now check names. Now if you see here, you can see the user, right? Bash 38. Always your username will be there with the computer name, guys. Bash 38 is my computer name, /Sudarshan is my username. If you see computer name slash username, that is local user. If you see domain name slash user, that is domain user. I'll explain what is domain and all. As of now, forget about it. So now Sudarshan is created in the Windows level. So that's why whenever I click check names, immediately, okay, we found that user. Now just click OK, guys. Okay, so I am not going to assign any permissions to Sudarshan on any database. In case Sudarshan wants to access sales Amazon database, okay, see here carefully. If you click Amazon database, see here in the user section, Amazon. See here, Sudarshan user is going to be created in the Amazon database. If I click OK, a login will be created in the SQL Server. A user will be created in the Amazon database, like how we discussed in the diagram. Same way, a user will be created in the Amazon database. Okay, I don't want to give permissions to Sudarshan on any database, so I'm simply unchecking it. Simply, I'll create a Sudarshan login. Just I'll give the name and I'll click OK. Right now, you can see here, Sudarshan login is created. Now, can anyone tell me? There are two questions now. You can see here, bash 38 Sudarshan. Okay, it will go to alphabetical order. I have two questions now. One question is, can Sudarshan connect to the SQL Server or not now? I didn't give any access to Sudarshan. Simply, I just created a Sudarshan login. Now, can Sudarshan connect to my SQL Server or not? Yes or no? You can tell any answer.
No, sir.
Yes.
Yes. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes. Yes.
Okay. So, lot of people are saying yes. The answer is okay. Yes. Sudarshan can connect to the database, SQL Server, not database, SQL Server. Why? Because I told you, right? Any login by default, it will have connect to SQL Server permissions. He can connect. If he is a member of this list, logins list, that particular person can connect to the SQL Server. No issues, he can connect. But he cannot access any database. Why? Because I didn't give any permissions on any databases to Sudarshan, right? He can only connect to SQL Server, but he cannot access any database. Now the second question is, Sudarshan wants to connect to the SQL Server. Now tell me how Sudarshan can connect to the SQL Server, this SQL Server, Bash 38 server. Okay, I'll give you the hint also. If I click connect button, I can see my name administrator, not my name, administrator name is coming. On behalf of this administrator, Bash 38 Sudarshan should come here. How can we get Bash 38/Sudarshan here? I cannot edit this name, guys. See here, this is grayed out. I cannot edit it. Don't ask me to choose SQL Server authentication and give Sudarshan name and Sudarshan password. No, that is wrong. Okay. I have to get name like this. Bash 38/Sudarshan, I have to get it. How can I get that name?
You have to log in with those credentials in the Windows Server.
Are you sure?
Yeah, with that user, with that login name and password.
Are you sure again?
Yeah.
And any other answers, guys, please?
Same answer, sir.
Same answer. Very good. Okay, so the answer is correct. Okay, as I logged in as an administrator. Okay, as I logged in as an administrator, that's why I got administrator name here. If I logged in as a Sudarshan, okay, I'll get Sudarshan login. I'll get Sudarshan name here. Okay, so what I'll do, I don't log off. Simply, I'll open the same management, one more management studio I'll open. Okay, so let me open management studio. Same management studio, I'll give the different name this time. So you can ask this question, whether it is going to, in case if you open different management studio, is it going to accept? Okay, again, if I open different management studio also, again, I'll get the same administrator. So what I have to do, so let me do like this, okay? So now what I have to do, you know, I have to log off from this machine. I have to log in directly. Why? Because Sudarshan doesn't have remote desktop permissions. So I'll do this way, in this way. I'll open this management studio using a different user option. Again, guys, just to show you, I am logging in as a Sudarshan. Once I created Sudarshan, I'll give username and password to Sudarshan so that Sudarshan can log in. Okay, so in case if you want to see that, let me show you. Okay, what I have to do, you know, I have to directly log into the machine. I don't want to confuse you. Okay, what I'll do, you know, I'll directly log into the machine. On be off of administrator, I'll use Sudarshan now. Okay, let me close this message boxes. I'll use Sudarshan now. You can see the Sudarshan, right? Log into Sudarshan, give the password. Now, once I logged into the server directly, the remote connection will be gone. Okay, it will be disconnected. I guess it is still there. Okay, it is still there. Okay, no problem then. If I use same user account, same administrator, I guess it will be disconnected. Okay. So now Sudarshan logged into the machine. Okay, if you want, you can see here Sudarshan. Now, if I open Management Studio, okay. Now, if I open Management Studio, so simply what I want to say is, I'll simply create a Sudarshan login and password and will give the credentials to him. So now Sudarshan is trying to access the server with his name. Nothing to worry, nothing is there in the security. Just you have to understand this logic. That's it. Remaining all things are very simple once you are good in these basics. Okay, nothing to worry. Just in case if you are still having confusion, go through the recordings again and again. Okay, so now you can see.
Users,
yeah.
While creating users, password will be same for all users.
No. We'll give the different password. See, that password, again, users we won't create. Windows people will create. Windows people don't give the password. Same password for all users. They will give different passwords. Again, I didn't select that option. If you go to the machine, see here. If I create new user with Nagesh, okay? Nagesh. So if I gave the password, different password I'll give. 123. Okay. So if you see here, user must change password at next login. If you choose this option, if I click create button, now next time I know your password. As I have created a password for you, I know your password. Now, in the organization, they will choose this option. User must change the password at next login. So once I gave the default password to you, if you're trying to log in with the same default password, okay, it will prompt you to change the password immediately as this option is selected. So immediately in the next screen, once you log in with the default password, immediately you have to change the password. Then only you can proceed. So later you will change your own password, right? So there is no chance of knowing your password to the Windows team or DBA team. others can't know your password. Only they know the default password, but again, yeah.
Okay, sir, if I change the password, if I forgot it later, then what
will happen? Later, they will completely reset it. They don't know. Then also, they don't know the password. They will simply reset the password. Okay, so it will give you again one more default password. Again, you will log in with the default password. Again, it will ask you to, again, it will prompt you to change the password immediately. Okay. Fine. Any questions? Right. And where we are? Yeah. So let me go to this machine. And now you can see here, right? Once I open Management Studio, and now I can see bash38/sudarshan.y because I just logged into my machine, okay, using Sudarshan account. So that's why whenever I open Management Studio, okay, it just pulls that particular user information, and it is showing Sudarshan now. Okay, clear? Any doubts, any issues, guys? Now Sudarshan can connect to the SQL server. See here, happily he can connect to the SQL server. But I'm sorry, in case if he is trying to expand the database Amazon, he will get the error like this. If he is trying to expand the sales database, he will get the error like this. Why he is getting the error? Why he's getting
didn't have he doesn't have a permission.
Sudarshan doesn't have permission.
Yes.
Sudarshan can log in, but he cannot access any database. Once we gave access to any database, once we gave access to Sudarshan on any database, if we gave access to Sudarshan on AdventureWorks, then he can expand the AdventureWorks and he can see what are the objects are there under AdventureWorks. If we gave access to sales database, he can expand sales database like this. See, I am a sysadmin. Okay, I can expand any database. I can see all the objects. Right? So if you go to here, I can expand the databases. Why? Because I'm a sysadmin. I'm having a lot of access. I mean, like I have privileges, all the privileges I have. So I can happily expand any database and I can see. But Sudarshan can't see anything. Why? Because we didn't give access to any database, okay, for Sudarshan. So that's why he cannot access it. By default, he can connect to SQL Server, but there is no use. He cannot read any data. He cannot view any data. Okay. So this is how.
So how we can raise the ticket, sir, for request?
We will have ticketing tools. Okay. ServiceNow is a kind of ticketing tool. Okay. Simply you have to mention, say, for example, Sudarshan wants to connect to the server, bash38 server. Okay. Now he will raise a ticket. So I need permissions to this server, bash38. He will mention the server name. He will mention the database name also. I want to access sales database, and I want to access in sales database, I want to access employee table, like that he will mention. If he need access on the whole database, we'll provide the access on whole database so that he can access all the tables. If he need access only on a specific data table, we'll simply provide the database server name, database name, table name. So that he has to provide in the ticket, so that we'll simply give access to that particular securables. Clear? Any issues, any doubts? Right, clear, right? Now let me create a SQL login. For SQL login, there is no prerequisite, guys. You can happily create a SQL login, okay? Right click, new, or else again, don't confuse. Right click on login, new login. I'll create, okay? This time I'll create a login with Joshi, okay? So choose SQL Server authentication. Choose SQL Server authentication. I'll give the password. Okay. Right. Here you can see here. Okay. Same options. Enforce password policy means strong passwords we have to give. Okay. Enforce password expiration. And you can see here user must change password at next login. Joshi, she just selected as a developer, SQL developer. She is not a DBA now. She just selected as a SQL developer in any organization. Some organization, she just got an offer as a developer. Now we have to create a login for Joshi. She is a developer, right? She wants to access the databases and all, connect to the servers and all. So we got a request. Joshi will not directly come to my desk, hey Shanmukh, give the permissions to me. No, she may be working from different location. Imagine she is working from US or she is working from Noida, she is working from Mumbai. Simply she will raise a ticket. I need access on this batch 38 server, on this particular sales database. In case she need access on table, she will mention the table also. Someone in the DBA, someone who is there in the shift from DBA team, they will check this ticket, they will open the ticket, they will see, okay, whatever permissions are needed for Joshi. And of course, Joshi has to provide the business justification why she wants to access the database or server. Means business justification means manager approval. Once manager approved, what DBA will do? Simply DBA will log into that particular batch 38 server. He will create a SQL login for Joshi and he will choose this option. User must change password at next login. As DBA gave the password, DBA knows the password, first password, default password. So DBA will tell the password to Joshi. Joshi, this is your username and this is your password. Please use this username and password to log into the server. Once she log into the server, let me show you that as well. Okay. Let me create Joshi login now. Fine. Now I want to log in as Joshi. You can use this management studio only. Okay. Let me connect. I will change the authentication to SQL authentication. Now Joshi is a SQL login, right? Okay. Now let me give the username as Joshi and let me give the password. So now tell me, can I connect to the SQL server or I'll get an error?
Yes, connected.
Yes, connected.
Are you sure?
Yes.
So I cannot connect to the SQL server. Why I cannot connect to the SQL server?
Didn't give permission.
Everything. Permission means I created the login, right? No need to give any permissions. What permission I gave to Sudarshan? No, right? I just simply created a login for Sudarshan. Sudarshan is connected happily without having any issues. But Joshi, why she is unable to connect? Okay, let me show you one thing. This is a SQL login, right? Nothing. The concept is same as it is. Again, don't confuse here. So usually while installing the SQL server, we just, okay, if you go to the security, we just configured our SQL server with Windows authentication. Means only Windows logins can connect to the SQL server, not SQL logins. Now, if you choose SQL server and Windows authentication, now SQL logins also can connect to my SQL server. Windows logins also can connect to my SQL server. Both logins can connect to my SQL server. So earlier it is Windows authentication, right? Only Windows logins can connect to my SQL server. That's why Sudarshan is connected. But Joshi is unable to connect. Why? Joshi is a SQL login. The SQL server is configured with Windows logins. So SQL login is unable to connect. I'm going to change the setting now. I'm going to change this to SQL server and Windows authentication so that Windows logins also can connect to my SQL server. SQL logins also can connect to my SQL server. Let me click OK. What it is saying, some of your configuration changes will not take effect until you restart the SQL server. So after change the setting, I have to restart the SQL server. Okay. Right click, restart it. It is going to ask yes or no. Click yes. Click yes again. Then it is going to restart. Right. SQL server is restarted. Now, can anyone tell me, can Joshi connect to my SQL server now?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes, yes.
Okay, so the answer is yes. She can connect to the SQL server now. Just a minute, okay? It is refreshing still. Okay, no problem. Not an issue. Right. Click on connect button. Choose SQL Server authentication. Now just type Joshi login username and give the Joshi password. Okay, so can anyone tell me what will be the next screen once I click connect?
Password.
Very good, excellent. Okay, just click connect. Yes, see here, it is asking for new password. As Joshi can log in to this SQL server with her new password, now Joshi is going to change her password. So even though a DBA can set the password for Joshi, but that password can't be used by Joshi. Immediately in the next login attempt, it is going to ask Joshi to change the password. Joshi is going to change the password now. Okay, now only Joshi knows her password. Okay, so even DB also don't know the Joshi password. So next time a DB also can't connect. What is that? New password false. It does not match the confirm password. Let me give the strong password. There are some password policies will be there. That is the main problem. Okay. I'll give Joshi at 1, 2, 3. I don't know whether it is going to accept or not. 1, 2, 3. Login failed for reason password. The change failed. The password does not meet operating system policy requirements because it is not complex enough. What password I have to give? Okay. Only 1, 2, 3. Come on. Okay, forget about it. Like this, she is going to get it. The password policy is somewhat difficult. Okay, let me reset the password for Joshi. Okay, let me go to the security logins. Where is Joshi? Joshi, double click on Joshi. Again, same concept will be there. Okay, so the problem here is, what is the problem I'm facing? I'm unable to change the password policy. It has to accept the new password, but there are a lot of challenges in setting the new password, guys. It won't accept less than 8 characters. It won't accept same series of passwords. It won't accept if any special characters are there. If any special characters are not there, are there. Okay, a lot of challenges are. So that's why I'm simply resetting the Joshi's password. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Simply, I'm giving 1, 2, 3 password. I'm unselecting this password policy now. Okay. The check policy and check expression cannot be turned off when the must change on. Check policy and check expression options. So the expiration is there. If you uncheck this one, all three are unchecked. Okay.